closer or further, and you happen to be awake at 2 a.m., step outside and just watch the north sky for half an hour. It should be a good show this year. Obviously can't guarantee that you will see meteors, but your chances are better than usual. That, by the way, applies only if you live in the northern hemisphere, so I'm sorry if you're south of the equator, you'll just have to wait for a different shower. Anyway, I just wanted to do a short update on my reading slump, which had been going on for about a month and hasn't been anymore because you were all very, very helpful, so thank you. his most famous novel is The Name of the Rose, which I cannot recommend because I have not read it yet. But it's on my list. I have a copy lying about here somewhere. I have 4 bookshelves in my room. All of them are packed. Of his works that I have read, my favorite is Modolino. And I love the first half of The Island of the Day Before. The second half, I'm only about 3/4 of the way through the book. I put it down for a little while. But the second half is not as much fun for me. I can't say that it's not going to be fun because I haven't finished it yet, but yeah, I'm just at the point I'm at. But the first half is stunning. So, I was talking about more A's and I got on an echo tangent. I'm sorry. But I feel like I can't really completely comment on him yet because I've read so little of him. But loving him. He's very Argentinian, insofar as I'm aware of the state of Argentinianism. It just, it fits. I think my favorite story of his that I've read so far is The Man on the Pink Corner. I'm scratching Costello behind the ears right now, sorry, it's a little distracting. But yeah, I will comment on him a little bit more as I've read more of him. I just don't feel quite well informed enough at this point. But does he get